Greetings to all. Welcome to the tutorial of relational operators, that is part 3. Relational operators specify the relation between two variables by comparing them. There are 6 relational operators in C++. Let's see. Equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Let's understand with the help of an example here. I am assigning 20 value to variable A and 30 value to variable B. So, look here in equal to operator, 20 is equal to 30? No. So, the result is false and the result in zeros and ones, that is 0. Next is not equal to. Fine. Not equal to. 20 is not equal to 30. The result is true. So we will get 1 as answer. Greater than. 20 is greater than 30. Then the result is false and 0. Less than. 20 is less than 30. That means we will get true value. And the result would be 1. Greater than or equal to, 20 is greater than or equal to 30. It is false. So we will get the output 0 here. And less than or equal to, 20 is less than or equal to 30. Result is false. And we will get 0 as an answer. One thing you have to keep in mind. If in a table the result is false. Result is false. Then output window will show answer 0. Okay. If the result is false, it will give 0 value in the output window. If our result is true, then it will give 1 in the output window. Okay. If our result is true, then it will give us answer 1. Clear? So, and one more important thing here, double equal to and single equal to are not the same thing. Fine. When we are talking about is equal to, that means we are assigning the value to that particular variable. Fine. And when we are talking about double equal to, equal to sign, that means variable, that particular variable is equal to that value. Here we are not assigning, that is equal to that variable. Clear? So let's understand relational operators with the help of an program. Here I have written a program, small short program here. Okay, I am declaring 3 variables A, B and C. And I am assigning the 12 value to variable A and 14 value to variable B. Now, come to this line. In this line, I am using greater than operator. Greater than operator. Here, I am comparing the both the variables, that is A and B. Here, I am saying 12 is greater than 14. Hey guys. Is it right or wrong? 12 is greater than 14. It's a false statement. So, as an output, we will get the 0 as a return. Clear? So, output window will give us 0 as an answer. If, let's see how. Look here. Okay? So, C is equal to 0 because 12 is less than 14 here. Fine. So, let's go back. If I will change the operator here, if I will do A is less than B. Yes, this is a true statement because 12 is less than 14. Okay. So, let's check the output again. What would be the output here? C is equal to 1 means our statement is here. Clear? So, same way, if I will put here equality, operator, sorry, equality operator. Fine, that means we are looking here that 12 value is equal to 14 or not. Yes, of course it is not equal to 14. Both are different values. So let's check the output again here. What would be the output here? It is 0. Yes, of course it is a false statement. That's why we are getting here 0 side by side. Clear guys? So, in this way we can check our output also, and we can check the other operators also. I hope you understood relational operators here. Thank you. Logical operators are used for identifying the truth value of the expression. Okay. Here, we are having three types of logical operators. Logical AND, logical OR, and logical NOT. We will understand these three operators one by one. So, I have assumed here the values also. Variable A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, C is equal to 30 here. So, let's see the example for logical AND. See, one thing you have to keep in mind that the results of these operators all depends on the truth table that I have mentioned here. Clear? So, we have to keep these tables in our mind when we are going to use any of the operator in the program. Clear? So, let's see example of logical AND. First operand is saying 10 is less than 20. That means it is true. Okay. Then after that, second one is saying 10 is greater than 30. That is false statement here. Okay. Now, if we will go to the truth table of logical AND, let's check here. First statement is true. Second operand is false. Then we will get false as a result. So here our result is false, and we will get, it will return the zero value for the false statement. Clear? Now, next is logical OR. Let's see its expressions. Operand 1 is saying 10 is less than 20. That is true. Operand 2 is saying 10 is greater than 20. It is false. Let's check in the truth table of logical OR. First operand is true, second operand is false, and we will get our result that is true here. Okay, same true here, and it will return us value 1 because our answer is true, our statement is true. Clear? Now, let's move to the logical NOT operator. Logical NOT operator is also known as unary operator. Unary operators. Okay, we have discussed earlier also in our previous video unary operator. Why do we call it unary operator? Because this is only applied on operand 1. Okay, it is only applied on operand 1, only expression 1 here. Okay, so let's see in the example, it is saying 10 is less than 20. 10 is less than 20. According to logical AND, it is saying the statement is false. Okay, logical NOT means basically, first of all, I'll tell you logical NOT again. It is mean not equal to. Okay, logical NOT means not equal to. So, it reverse the state of its operand. That means true will become false and vice versa, false will become true here. Okay, so it is saying this statement is true. Okay, according to this, of course 10 is less than 20 here. Okay, so operand 1, our answer is true here, but logical NOT will reverse true into false. So, as a result, we will get false here and output would be 0. It will return the 0 value. Clear? According to logical NOT,
it is saying it is true. Fine. But when we will get the result, okay, it is true, but it will reverse the statement, means it is saying false, because logical not is saying it is a false statement. Okay. Obviously, it is saying 10 is not less than 20, but although it is true. Okay. True. Although the statement is true here. Fine. I hope you understood this. Now we will see the program, small program, in the next slide, and it will be more clear to you. So thank you.
So let's understand logical operators with the help of an example, with the help of program. Here I am initializing four variables A, B, C, D. Okay. So, and I have assigned, you can see here, I have assigned the different values to all four variables. Okay. So, let's come to the next line here. I am using the AND operator. AND operator, that means if the operands, if both the operands are non-zero, then the condition will become true here. Okay. So, let's compare the expression 1 here. That is saying A is greater than B. That means 5 is greater than 2. It is true. Okay. Now let's go to the expression 2 here. It is saying 5 is less than 8. Okay. So both the answers are true here. Okay. So let's check its output. Let's compile it first. And after that, let's see the output. The both the conditions are true here, the answer would be true. Let's see here. The output is 1 because our statement is true here. Okay. If suppose one of the statement is false here. Okay. So let's check. I'm saying here now 5 is less than 2. That means false statement. And C is less than A, D. Okay, that means 5 is less than 8 here. So, one is false statement, the another one is true statement. The answer would be false. It will return us 0 value. Let's compile. Okay, and let's check the output screen here. So, here we are getting the 0 as output. So, that means our statement was false. Okay. So, now let's again, same way we can use the logical OR and logical NOT. Okay. So, let's go to the logical NOT. Logical NOT. Okay. So, here I need only two variables and this symbol. And I am removing, I don't need C and D variable here, so I am deleting it. Okay, so let's see the output over here. Let me compile. It is saying A is less than B, means it is false, but you know logical NOT, what it does, if the condition is true, then logical NOT operator will make it false. If it is false, then logical NOT operator will make it true statement. Okay. So, let's see. Let's compile first. Okay. And let's check the output here. See. So, logical NOT make the false statement true here. So, we have got the 1 as answer here. I hope you understood the concept of logical operators here with the help of a small program. Thank you.